I was raised in a home with loving Christian parents and five sisters. My childhood was pretty normal for the most part. I did everything you know a normal child did. I went to church, and I was involved in school, involved in sports. And as I went through school, though, I didn't fit in a lot. I was picked on and didn't feel liked. I lost confidence and felt a lot of rejection. And as a child, I didn't have an established relationship with Christ. And so I didn't really know how else to deal with this except for looking for acceptance from everyone else around me. I continued on through school, and eventually I started to lose my eyesight and found out I'm legally blind. This was really devastating for me, and it just made me feel like, you know, I was less of a person than everyone else around me. In grade 8, I started smoking marijuana and cigarettes quite regularly. In grade 9, I found out my mom had a brain tumor, and this is where everything just kind of went completely downhill. I really loved my mom, and it really hurt me, and I couldn't understand how God could let that happen to a good Christian woman like my mom. And so at this point, I turned my back on him completely. After my mom's surgery, she was prescribed pain medication, and I started to steal her pain meds to get high. This led me into a regular use of morphine and OxyContin, and which quickly became an addiction. I started doing everything for this drug, and was just living a party life. My parents caught on, and eventually I just got kicked out of the house. While living on my own, I dropped out of high school and was breaking into houses and into cars and stealing from my own parents to try and support my habit. I ended up moving in with a guy who got a large inheritance of money from his grandpa's death, and this brought me into the use of almost every other drug, but mainly cocaine and ecstasy. Eventually it just spiraled down so badly that I felt like I had nothing left to live for. I felt hopeless and just completely, you know, wrecked by the life I was living. And I felt I wanted change and didn't really know what to do, so I cried out to God. And at this time, my pastor called and asked me if I wanted to come and see Teen Challenge because they were coming to the church. And so I really had nothing better to do, so I decided I would go and check it out. I heard 3 testimonies of guys who had lives probably worse than I had. And, you know, I just realized I still had a chance, and you know, if I would just surrender my life to God, that, you know, I had hope that he could turn things around. And so I agreed. My mom helped me apply, and I got accepted into the program. Since being at Teen Challenge, you know, God has just transformed my life in so many ways. I came in confused, lost, and just I felt hopeless, and I felt there was just absolutely nothing left for me. But now I've gotten the opportunity. I have my high school diploma now. I plan on going to college. And can just see things through new eyes, you know, and like it says in Jeremiah, you know, God has a plan and a hope for a good future for me. You know, and my disability doesn't really bother me anymore either. I hold Romans 8:28 really close to me, that all things work together for good. And, you know, I remember Paul and James just rejoicing in their sufferings, and I have an understanding now of why, and it's, I found that in the verse in 2 Corinthians 12, verses 8 to 10. And that is, 3 times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away from me, but he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses and insults and hardships and persecutions and in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong. And all these days I spend away.
Think about it.